Okay, chair yoga for Anne, one of my yoga students who is using a boot on and off at the moment because of a broken bone in her foot. So, this is not the ideal chair, but we're going to use that because it's available. And let's get started. So, as always at the start of our classes, we make sure that we sit for a moment to breathe, to tune into the body. Be sure that the spine is in an upright or neutral position, so no kind of bending over or slouching. Take a moment. Tune into your body. How are you feeling right now? Where in the body are you feeling tension? For sure, there's going to be some unusual tension due to using the boot. So, just being aware of all of that, being really aware of your body, and then take some deep breaths. Slowing everything down, always slow right down before your yoga practice to make sure that you practice very consciously and safely. If you rush, you're more likely to do some silly damage to yourself that's very, very avoidable. So always slow down first, breathing nice and deeply right down into the belly and up into the chest, and exhaling out fully, emptying the lungs. Slow yourself down, let your shoulders drop, let your belly relax. Start with some neck stretches, and you mentioned that your neck is particularly tight, so we're going to spend a little more time there. We start with chin to chest. Let the weight of your head gently stretch the back of your neck. Take your time. Relax. Notice where the tension is. Feel it more on one side? Does it travel into your shoulders, your back? Lifting up, chin to ceiling. Bring your head back. Just be careful, this point in the neck can be quite sensitive. Keep your jaw closed but without clenching so you feel a stretch on the front of the throat as well. Breathe. Notice if the movement feels restricted when you bring your head back, or does it feel easy? Chin to chest again. This time, move your head very gently from side to side. Nice and slow so that you get the maximum stretch. Keep breathing. Keep your spine in that neutral or upright position. Notice what you can feel. Where does the tension travel? Is it very tense? Or have you got lots of movement there, nice and easy? Exhale, try to relax. When you feel ready, come back up. This time we're going to turn the head, look over the shoulder. Exhale, inhale as you come back to the center. Exhale over the other shoulder. Inhale back to the center. Exhale over the shoulder. Inhale back to the center. Exhale over the shoulder. Back to center, inhale. Roll the shoulders. Big circles. Sometimes what we need more than really deep or intense stretching is movement. So move. Move plenty. Round the other way. Keep breathing. Notice what you can feel and where. Really important that we're conscious of the body. Relax. Now roll the wrists. And the other way. Keep breathing. Open and close fists. Wriggle all of the fingers. Shake it out. Just be careful if you have armrests. Okay. Interlace your fingers. This time you can round your back a little. Pull your hands forward. So be careful that you don't start to lift your shoulders up towards your ears. But you can bring the hands down or bring the hands up. Really pull far forward. Notice where you feel the stretch and hold it where you need it. So here feels like a good point for me. And maybe here too. Sit back up tall again. Shake it out. Arm across the chest. Be careful you don't lift your shoulder up. You can lift the arm up a little bit more or down, but not the shoulder. We don't want to end up twisting. Hold above the elbow, or you can hold below and breathe. Where you feel this stretch will change depending on where you have the tension in your body. Sometimes I feel it in my tricep here at the back of the upper arm, and more often it's around the back of the shoulder or right into the shoulder blade. Depending on what other exercise I have been doing, or if I've slept strangely, can change where you feel the tension. Over to the other side. So release slowly, shake out. Arm across, be careful that you don't lift your shoulder up, but you can lift the arm up or down a little bit if you like. Watch this shoulder. Above the elbow or below the elbow, and pull gently. Slowly release and shake it out. Okay, behind your back. It may not be possible to interlace your fingers behind your back and pull back because we have a chair here if you're doing chair yoga. So just take a hold of your elbows behind your back, roll your shoulders back as far as they'll go, and push your chest forward a little. So we kind of just work on pulling the shoulders back to stretch across the collarbone and maybe into the pecs a little bit. And just doing this, holding on close to the elbows and pulling back gently. So I'm not sitting with my back right into the back of the chair. If you are, if you have space, maybe you can put your arms around the back of the chair. Or sit forward onto the edge of the chair, just be careful that you don't lose your balance. But we really want to focus on pulling the shoulders back, roll them back, and lift the arms a small bit away from you to increase the stretch. Slowly release. And shake it out. Okay, now we're going to do another stretch in this direction. Eagle pose. Please be careful and just go as far as you need to into the stretch. We'll call it different levels. Stick with level one if that gives you enough of a stretch. Only go to level two if you need to in order to feel a stretch. And likewise with level three, level four. So we bring the arms up, bent at the elbows, 90 degrees, not down here, but up with elbows at the height of your shoulders here. Bring your forearms together, elbows together and hands together. Careful of your shoulders again. Try not to lift them up. And for sure, if you start to lift one shoulder higher than the other, you're going to end up pulling something out of place. Or maybe there's something out of balance already. So be mindful of your shoulders. Level one. If you need to go further to get the stretch, we go to level two. Right hand goes underneath. I place the just above the elbow into the crease of the other arm. Hands back to back. Maybe that's enough. Maybe you have to hold onto a finger like this. Or maybe you can bring the hands back to back. Watch my shoulders. I'm still not lifting one shoulder higher than the other. They're level. Breathe. To go to level three, bring this hand round once more. So we press the fingers into the palm of the other hand. Watch my shoulders. They're still not uneven. Level four, lift up. Just lifting with the fingers and with the elbows. Watch my shoulders. I'm not lifting my shoulders up. Still level. only go this far into it if you need to feel the stretch. Be careful, because you're going to be stretching across your shoulder blades. There's a lot of different ligaments and all sorts of different things going on in the muscles back there, muscle attachments, etc. So don't overdo it. Just go as far as you need to feel the stretch. Slowly come down. Unravel gently. Shake it out. And then we go to the other side. Don't forget to breathe. So level one, remember, elbows up here. Elbows and hands together. Watch what you're doing with your shoulders. Breathe, keep your back straight. Mind what you're doing with your neck. So try not to be looking up or looking in towards your chest. Keep your neck in neutral as well. Level two, this time the left hand goes under. Hands back to back. Watch the shoulders. Hand round once more for level three. Level four, lift up. Only go to level four if you need to. Only go to level three if you need to. Everyone's body will be very different. Also, if you have an injury, it may feel very different in your body. So go slowly. Even if you were able to do this last week, you might not be able to do it today. Only go to the level that you need to feel the stretch. Never force your body. Slowly back down, unravel, and shake it out. Roll your shoulders again, move your neck gently and slowly. If you're still feeling a lot of tension in the neck and shoulders, head to the side gently, and use your hand to stretch a little bit deeper. Very gently, not too much. Breathe. Maybe change the angle a little bit. Make sure you get the stretch exactly where you need it. Breathe, try to relax. Let go gently. Now bring your head back to the center. The neck can be sensitive, so be careful. Other side. Gently using the hand to stretch a little bit further. Change the angle slightly, making sure you get the stretch exactly where you need it. Keep breathing. Keep your back in neutral. Slowly, then bring your head back to the center. Nice and gently, maybe you feel like you need to move a little bit more. And then we move on. Okay, gently try to stretch your sides. You can stand up for this part if you like, or leaning gently to one side, stretch over yourself. Be careful that you don't lose your balance on your chair. If it's easy to touch the floor, maybe touch the floor while you're doing this. Please be careful, if you're on a stool, for example, that you don't fall over to one side. If it's better and it's comfortable, you can come up onto your feet and do this. Repeat on each side. Inhale as you come to center. Exhale over the other way. Might not be possible to touch the floor. My seat of my chair is down quite low, so you may hold on to the arm of the chair, being super careful not to lose your balance, or come up onto your feet. Be sure that you repeat on each side. The aim here is to stretch along your side, from your hip, up along to the ribs, the pecs, the shoulder. Now, while you're on your feet, gentle forward bend, folding from your hips. Keep your back in neutral, keep it straight. Do Just go as far as you need to feel the stretch. That might be here. Keep your shoulders back a little. Or maybe you go deeper into it. But if you have to force it and you end up rounding your back in funny places, come up. So for sure, the legs are going to be tight. If there has been an injury in the leg, if you've been wearing a boot. So take your time. Maybe you want to rest the hands on the legs for a little bit of support, or let yourself hang. Just be careful that you keep your back in neutral, that you're not bending here or here, because then you lose the stretch here when you do that. Take your time, breathe. The aim is to stretch out the back of the leg. Just be careful of the injured leg. If the twisting motion is not comfortable, or you don't feel okay doing that with the injury, then leave that part out. Just nice and gently, maybe come up a little bit and down and up and so on. Okay, so forward bends. Don't worry if you can't touch the floor. You can hold onto your chair, maybe resting the hands on the chair. The aim here is to stretch out the muscles in the back chain, back of the legs, glutes, into your lower back. When you're ready to come up, if you're using your chair, use the support of the chair to come up gently and round your back a little at the last minute. If you're not using the chair, as usual, you can round your back to roll up. Okay, some stretches for the legs. Let me come a little bit closer. It's starting to get dark now. Gently, and hold on to something for balance if you like, rolling each ankle. Nice and gently. If it doesn't feel right, if you don't feel safe with the injury, leave this part out. Flex and extend. Flex and extend. Wriggle all the toes. Heel down, toes up. Toes down, heel up. Side. Holding on to some things, make sure you feel safe and secure. Roll. If you need to do this seated in the chair so that you're not standing on the injured leg, you can do that too. Wriggle all the toes, flex and extend. Heel down, toes up. Again, you could do this seated in your chair if you like. Toes down, heel up. Repeat. If possible, feet open and roll your hips. Let me see if I can get some more light here. The hips, the hip flexors, the glutes are probably going to feel the impact of a foreign object on your foot, the boot that you're wearing intermittently. So give them a good rub. Bigger circles if you feel comfortable doing so, but always be conscious of the injury. Well, be mindful of the injury so that you can take care of it, and don't do anything that doesn't feel right. Circles in both directions for your hips, and breathe. Breathe out any of that tension that's built up in the body. So from standing, or if you want to be seated again, we'll twist, gently turning your torso. Hold on if you have a handle here, or the back of the seat maybe, or just hold on, pushing one hand into the legs, depending on what chair you're using. Breathe, round the other way. So this will be more for your back. Repeat. feet. If you want to go a bit deeper, you can push that a little bit more. Maybe bring the hand onto the back of the chair to help you twist a little bit more. Breathe. Look right over your shoulder. Be careful you don't bring your shoulders up towards your ears. Repeat on the other side. And be mindful of armrests if you have them. A little bit of helicopter. Open your knees, bring your torso down the center. You can push the knees open wide if you like to stretch the inside of the legs. Just be mindful, of course, of the injury. So I'm kind of pushing like so. Depends on your chair again. You might need to come to the edge. Be careful not to lose your balance. And I'm keeping my back straight and really kind of pushing my chest forward slightly. Make prayer position here to stretch the wrists a little if you like. Nice deep breaths. And then letting the torso come down into the center to stretch. Maybe alternating between rounding your back and lifting up a little. Time. Just settle into it. Stretch out anything that feels tight. I'm feeling it mostly on the inside of my thighs. You may feel it on your back if your back's tired. And then I would repeat these exercises a few more times, particularly as the physio or the doctor told you that these would be good for the injury. So repeat at will. Stretching the muscles gently, keeping the movement going. Remember, movement is sometimes what we need more than deep stretching. So for the injuries, you want to focus more on movement to make sure things don't seize up on you. And then the stretching will be more for the parts of your body that are starting to feel the strain of walking strangely with the boot, for example. One foot being a little bit higher than the other when the boot's on, that kind of thing. And maybe the inactivity as a result of the injury. Muscles can get a bit tight because of that. So repeat anywhere that you felt was particularly tight and tense, or repeat the whole lot if you like. Lots of breathing, let go of any stress. And when you're meditating, maybe bring in lots of healing energy into the place that's injured. You can even place your hands there and imagine channeling or visualize or have the intention of channeling the healing energy in there.